This is Good Morning Mumbai with Rishi K.
Brand new week of talking finance with Saurabh Mittal. Hi, how's your weekend, buddy?
All good, Rishi.
Listen, today let's talk about asset allocation strategies. But before that, let's define what we're getting into. What really is asset allocation?
Yeah, so I'll just give you a definition which is available on the internet. And I'm sure people who are missing this show will find this on internet and they'll just go bonkers because it only increases the complexity for them. Probably this is one more reason for them to listen to this show. So asset allocation is defined as an investment strategy by which an investor or a wealth manager attempts to balance risk versus reward. Now, he does this by adjusting the percentage of amount invested in an asset of a portfolio according to the risk tolerance of the investor, her goals, and the investment time frame.
That's really a little complex. Would you just break it down into more simpler terms?
Sure. So let me just first start, what are assets? You know, what do we really call assets? So broadly, there are four types of asset classes. These four asset classes can be divided into two groups. So first group is financial assets, which consist of fixed income and equities. Fixed income is just a fancy word for instruments such as fixed deposits, time deposits, or for that matter, any investment which gives you a fixed rate of interest. Equities, on the other hand, are the shares of companies, which basically allows you to participate in the profits of the companies. The second group is real assets, and as the name suggests, the first asset class in this is real estate, which is anything like our land, homes, office, godowns, etc. And lastly, there are commodities such as gold or silver.
Okay, so let me get this straight. We have four asset classes: fixed income, equities, real estate, and gold.
Right.
Now, how do they help in managing our money?
So these asset classes serve different purposes. For example, equities are volatile, fixed income gives us regular cash flow, gold is a good hedge against inflation, so on and so forth. Hence, an appropriate allocation should be created by investing a certain percentage of wealth in each of these asset classes.
Fair enough. So now we understand what asset allocation really is. What are the benefits and how can we go about doing it?
So one should take into consideration that risk mitigation is the most important characteristics of asset allocation. When an investor's portfolio is diversified in different instruments, risk arising from news-based event will not have major impact. So let me give you an example. If RBI decides to cut interest rates, then the interest yield on fixed deposits will go down. But conversely, as this move makes loans cheaper for the companies, their profit margin will rise. Better earnings will attract higher prices, which will create a positive impact on equities. So on one side, when you see that the interest rates are going down, it is impacting your fixed deposit. But on the other side, it is increasing your equity allocation.
So basically what you're saying is that it takes away the pressure of an unforeseen event.
Correct.
So the formula itself seems to be simple, Saurabh, but can we do it ourselves is the big question.
Right. So I mean, this is what we say. We at Circle Wealth Advisors believe that the right asset allocation is the crux of any investment strategy. As they say, many things in life are simple but not easy. Arriving at the right asset mix and then rebalancing it takes huge amount of discipline, and they face various complexities. For example, it should be taken into consideration that real estate, insurance, and fixed income instruments with long maturity dates are illiquid and cannot be rebalanced on a particular date every year. Such challenges must be carefully looked into while creating a portfolio. Also, you know, during the week, we'll discuss three different strategies for asset allocation.